What is up, y'all? I said, what is up? This is your boy, RigGaming27. I am back again with the Nintendo Switch discussions. I have a lot of stuff to talk to y'all about with the Nintendo Switch. It's going to take me a whole bunch of videos to get exactly what I have on my chest. And it's positive. Really positive. And, you know, like I say, if y'all are a Nintendo gamer, you love Nintendo, you want a lot of Nintendo content, this is a channel that you want to be subscribed to. I'm very excited to talk Nintendo again. It's been a while since I gave you a lot of content, a lot of Nintendo content in a row, because there was just nothing to talk about. I did not want to just keep talking about rumors. And now since we got facts, I'm ready to talk about this Nintendo Switch, because I'm so excited about this. I'm so hyped about this. And today I want to talk about the top five reasons that the Nintendo Switch can, they need to do for this console to succeed. And I guess my number five reason for it to succeed is, let me get my notes out. Better online functionality. We know that the Wii U's online was dog shit. It was better than the Wii, but the Wii was garbage as hell. But it was better, the Wii was better, but it still didn't hold a candle to the PSN and the Xbox Live. And playing Smash Bros. Online was bad. It was crappy as hell. And I kind of wish Nintendo would have added Ethernet port, and you know, so we could get a better online experience. And just playing stuff on Wi-Fi all the time, you just don't get a good experience when you play on Wi-Fi all the time. They need to add an Ethernet port on the Nintendo Switch, in which I'm not even sure if they even showed that, but that is really, really key. They need to have that's really important to have an Ethernet port, because I play online with Ethernet. I need to be hardwired. Okay, so basically, yes, online functionality, and basically, if they would have free online like they did this generation, then I would really, really be excited for this system, because I'm paying $120 a year for Xbox Live and PlayStation Network. I think it's ludicrous. I think it's ridiculous, stupid, because a lot of people on the PC side is laughing at us because their online is free. I know. There's some stuff on the PC side I would love to have over there on the console side, but it is what it is. You know, but if we can have a better online functionality and free online, man, that's a complete day one buy for me. No, I'm gonna get it anyway, because I love Zelda and I love Mario, and the sense is that we're gonna have a new mainline Mario game, 3D Mario game, day one, plus Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. I'm really excited, so I'm gonna get it. And I just love the concept of this system. So yeah, that's my top five. That's my top five. I still got four left. So that's my number five on this list. So my number four is better features. You have to have better features, especially in the year 2016. The Xbox One, the PlayStation 4 has a lot, and Nintendo needs to fall in line. They need to see what's hot out there. They need to see what's hot and what's not. And if trophies and achievements, it's been hot for over 10 years. I wish Nintendo could do some kind of achievement trophy list. Maybe have some kind of My Nintendo Points, whatever. Have a better notification bar. Like, I don't want to see no damn blue screen on a goddamn tablet. And we don't know who the fuck is this. We don't know who is sending a message. We don't know who is online. Like, Nintendo, y'all can do a better job than that. A better job, man. You gotta have a better notifications on that. And what else? Party chat. Like I've been hearing this a lot. A lot of Nintendo fanboys been damage controlling this for a very long time, in which that's why I kind of dripped away from the Nintendo community, because a lot of the Nintendo fanboys was damage controlling for Nintendo. Be like, why you need, you know, party chat? Why you need voice chat in this game? Like, you know, you don't need it, you know, so people can cuss you out and say all kinds of nasty, dirty, you know, words to you. Like, come on, man. Have you ever heard of options? You can always mute somebody. Like, I'm sick and I'm tired of that freaking argument. Like, it's so many features that the Wii U was missing. And I wish that the fans, Nintendo fans, called them out for it. I know, yes, a lot of us did call them out, but it just wasn't enough. But it was enough for Nintendo to change the concept of their system. It was enough for them to change how they advertise. You know what? I won't say that, because that's one of my top five. Okay, let's go ahead and go to number three. My number three of the top five reasons that the Nintendo Switch can succeed. Number three, is third-party support. Third-party support, I know a lot of y'all wanted this to be either number two or number one, but I'm going to explain why. Yes, third-party support, it takes up 75% of Xbox One's and the PlayStation 4 gaming library, and it's really key that you have third-party support. Because, you know, you got games like Red Dead Redemption, Grand Theft Auto, Assassin's Creed, you know, FIFA, Madden, NBA 2K, Mass Effect, in which I don't think it's not coming to the Nintendo Switch. You know, lots of games, lots of popular games that's on the Xbox One and the PS4, you know. That's why a lot of people is happy to be an Xbox One owner and a PlayStation 4 owner, because they know, they guaranteed that they're going to get these games. That's why I own every system, so I won't miss out on these games. I'm just a gamer. I love video games. Even though with the Wii U, I enjoyed it, you know, at some point. But whenever games stopped coming to the system, I was really, really pissed off. Really heated, man. But I was like, man, if Nintendo could get all these games, man, third-party support, first-party support, what's the reason of owning a PlayStation 4 and an Xbox One? Why do you need it? But Nintendo gave us a reason why you should own an Xbox One and a PlayStation 4, man. You need third-party support. It's really, really key. Nintendo, this is not the 80s no more. Y'all don't control this no more. Y'all can't monopolize this gaming industry like I used to no more, because third parties is basically a lot more bigger than what they used to be, man. So that's why they are getting the short end of the stick nowadays, because a lot of these companies got a bad taste in their mouth of what Nintendo did back in the day. So yeah, third-party support is really key. They really need it, because I love third-party games. Number two of my top five reasons that the Nintendo Switch can succeed, number two is advertising. The Wii U, oh my God, advertising was horrible. Even though when they did advertise some of these games, it was horrible, because they're using children, and that a lot of adults that are gamers, they can't take Nintendo serious, because they got little children in commercials with a goddamn chart telling their parents why they should buy them a Wii U. Like, how the hell can I take them serious? If I'm a gamer, it's more adult gamers out there than children, so how can I take Nintendo serious if they continuously and market their system with little children and babies on their damn commercials? So I'm really glad, I'm really happy that Nintendo changed the concept of their advertising by using young adults in their 20s and early 30s to advertise their new system. That was great. I love that trailer. I'm just so happy. I'm happy that they actually listened to us this time. They are actually listening to all the criticism that they've been getting this past couple years. Their advertising has did a complete 180, and I'm happy that Nintendo did that. You need to advertise your products if you want your products to sell, if you want your products to succeed. So I'm gonna give it to Nintendo. Matter of fact, their YouTube video, the Nintendo Switch first look, got over 17 million views. It said almost 500,000 likes versus 20,000 dislikes. That's a really, really good ratio, man. A lot of people is loving this concept. So it's up to Nintendo to give us more reasons to love this system. I'm loving it right now, but it's still a lot of questions that needs to be answered. And I'm still excited. So advertising is really, really key. Okay, number one, so I can hurry up and finish this goddamn video. Number one reason for the Nintendo Switch to succeed. I know a lot of y'all wanted third-party support. I know a lot of y'all wanted advertising. But what makes Nintendo Nintendo? Y'all tell me. What makes Nintendo Nintendo? You need first-party games. You need first-party games. Like, if it wasn't for Nintendo's first-party IPs, then Nintendo wouldn't be here. Like, we love our Marios, we love our Donkey Kong, Zelda's, Metroid. We missed out on a lot of first-party IPs this generation. Like, Nintendo, like, I would kill for a Metroid Prime for Nintendo, not a Federation Force. Y'all troll the hell out of us, man. I'm such a huge fan of Zelda, not Zelda, well, I'm a huge fan of Zelda, you know, too, but I'm a huge fan of the Metroid series, man, and Nintendo failed to deliver on that aspect. I'm really, really, really anxious to see what kind of first party games we're going to get on the Nintendo Switch. And I'm really happy that they merged their handheld department with their consoles so they could focus on, you know, giving us a console experience with the 3DS games. Like, you got the Fire Emblems, you got Bravely Defaults, you got the Monster Hunters, Phoenix Wright. You got all these great 3DS games that I would love to play on my console. So first party IPs is really key, because we missed out on F-Zero last generation. We missed out on Metroid. We missed out on Kid Icarus. You know, we missed out on Animal Crossing. You know, or Eternal Darkness. You know, so a lot of freaking games we missed out on. We missed out on, I won't say, well, Monster Hunter, it's not a first part. It's really more of a, like a, it's really more of like a third party exclusive, because, you know, Nintendo and Capcom, they got a really good relationship as far as their 3DS games. But, you know, there's a lot of games, a lot of first party, a lot of second party games that we did not get on the Wii U. Like, it's a lot of Nintendo games that I would love to play on my console. I love the Kirby games that was on the 3DS. The Triple Deluxe was a really good game. You know, there was a lot of good games on the 3DS. You know, and the Kirby game that we got was Rainbow Curse. Come on, Nintendo. Who the hell wanna play Rainbow Curse, man? Like, come on. Like, I swear that we got the dumbed down version of the 3DS games, even though it looked better on the console, but 3DS get the better games. Like, come on, Nintendo, you can do better than that. But like I said, I'm very excited that they merged the handheld with the console, and I'm pretty sure pretty soon the 3DS is going to get phased out, and they're going to focus everything on the Nintendo Switch, and we get to have more of a variety of games. Even though if third-party support don't fully, it's not going to fully be there as far as multiplats, but as far as third-party exclusives, in which what they got on the 3DS get to come on the Nintendo, I can't fucking talk. It all going to come on the Nintendo Switch, in which I will be very happy and very excited. So yeah, guys, that's basically my top 5 reasons that the Nintendo Switch can't succeed. You gotta have better online, better features, better third party, advertising, and more first party IPs. And, you know, like I said, we was missing a lot of first party IPs. Nintendo got them. They have a lot of first party IPs. That's why Nintendo's so well respected. They got so many games. And, you know, they got so many games in their library that in which it scares a lot of third parties. It scares them. That's why a lot of third parties don't want to make games for their system, because everybody going to flock off to their first party IPs. Everybody going to flock off to the freaking Zeldas and Mario Karts and Smash Brothers. You know, like, it's kind of hard to outsell those games. You know, if you put a Assassin's Creed or Madden or Call of Duty on a Nintendo system, and you got a mainline 3D Mario game right beside it, guess who's going to sell more? Like, I kind of understand, but Nintendo needs to have better relationships with third parties, so people can know that those third-party multiplats is going to be available for the Nintendo Switch. Because I remember during the beginning of the Wii U's generation, when there was some third-party multiplats that was actually, when they was actually supporting the Wii U, like, whenever you see the commercials, and when, you know, you can tell, like, which system is those games going on. You know, you got the PS4, Xbox One, PS3, and 360. And I never see a Wii U, even though some of those games did go on the Wii U, like Black Ops 2. You know, you got Assassin's Creed 2, and you got Assassin's Creed 3 and Black Flag. And of course, you got NBA 2K. I'm not sure if it was 2K13. It might have been 2K13. But a lot of those multi-plats that went on the Wii U, you never see a Wii U symbol on a commercial. But you see everything else. Nintendo need to have better third-party relationships with them, so people can know that these multi-plats exist on the Nintendo console, so people can go out and actually buy these damn games. So that's been, like I said, that's my top 5 reasons. I know that it was a long video, but I just had to get this off my chest. But expect a lot more Nintendo Switch content to come. And I'm just, like I said, guys, I'm so freaking excited. I know that I've been bashing Nintendo for the past couple of years. It's as far as a Nintendo fan, it's been rough, man. This is coming from an ex Sega fan. I grew up on Sega. That was my first console. Sega was my first love. And I will hate for my second love, Nintendo, to leave this gaming industry, because I don't know what to do no more. Because I started gaming back in 91, like, Nintendo and Sega was the hot shit, man. Like, Sega's gone. Well, they're not fully gone. As far as console wise, they're still making games, but they don't make consoles no more. But Nintendo, they still make games and consoles. But I would hate for Nintendo to just leave the gaming market and just make just fully concentrate on software. Some people think it's a good thing for them to concentrate on software, but as far as a longtime Nintendo fan, I would hate for them to do that. That's why I'm loving the concept. I really believe that it's going to be a really good seller. I'm not sure if it's going to sell as well as the Wii, but it's going to sell way more than the Wii U. It's a good concept. It's getting a lot of really good reception, and I'm digging it. We still got more questions. There's a lot more questions that needs to be answered from Nintendo. I hate that they're going to wait until next year to give us more questions, but it is what it is. Right now, I'm loving what I'm seeing. But guys, y'all just let me know how y'all feel about this video. I know that y'all might have a different top five than me, but this is just my personal top five, and y'all just give me y'all top five in the comment section below. And like I said, man, if you're a huge Nintendo fan, subscribe to this channel. I got a lot more Nintendo content to come. And follow me on Twitter, follow me on Facebook, Xbox Live, PlayStation Network. Even follow me on Nintendo, even though I'm barely on my Wii. Everything's in the link in the description below. Like, comment, subscribe to this channel. Once again, this is your boy, Regamer27, and y'all have a good day.